Greetings everyone, I am Shujat Ali from Medical's Lectures by Shujat, and today we are going to talk about upper limb muscles and not.
Muscle right here, this is trapezius muscle, originating from occipital bone and ligamentum nuchae and inserting at lateral third of clavicle and spine. So next muscle is basically latissimus dorsi. As we are seeing latissimus dorsi, so latissimus dorsi is basically originating from spinous processes of T7 to T12, as we are seeing T7 to T12, and inferior third to fourth rib from ribs. So inserting is at intertubercular groove of humerus, as we are seeing here. So it is inserting there. So next muscle is rhomboid major muscle. Rhomboid major muscle originating from T2 to T5 spinous processes and inserting it at a medial border of scapula. And on inferior of this we have rhomboid minor. As we are seeing, there is rhomboid minor and rhomboid major muscles. So origination of rhomboid minor is at ligamentum nuchae, and insertion of rhomboid minor is at the medial border of scapula as well as near the base of spine of scapula. So next muscle we have levator scapulae muscle. So levator scapulae muscle is basically originating from C1 to C4 cervical vertebras and inserting at superior medial border of superior medial angle and base of spine of scapula. So next muscle is we have pectoralis major muscle. We also says this muscle as chest muscle because most compartment of chest we are combining with that of pectoralis major. So here is an insertion groove for that, origin on mid clavicular line from sternal head, and overall this is pectoralis major. On behind it we have pectoralis minor muscle, and here we are seeing the muscles of arm, the muscles of upper part of arm. We have supraspinatus here, infraspinatus, teres minor, teres major, tricep, brachii, its lateral head, its long head, and medial head. And right now here we have bicep brachii muscles, and conius muscle, which is a small muscle that is triangular and is sometimes blended with tricep brachii and extensors. Furthermore, talking about thenar muscles and hypothenar muscles, we have flexor pollicis brevis, abductor pollicis brevis, open ends muscle. Thenar muscles, they basically move thumb, and hypothenar muscle there include flexor digiti minimi, abductor digiti minimi, and palmar aponeurosis. And here we have extensor pollicis longus, brevis, and abductor pollicis longus. Now moving towards the forearm, and this position we have flexor digitorum profundus, flexor pollicis longus, and palmaris longus muscle in forearm, flexor carpi ulnaris, flexor carpi radialis, and this muscle is also showing flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. Now we're moving toward brief detail in our laboratory, so we're moving towards that. So stay tuned. Now moving toward the hand and the forearm part and muscles of these. So this is a picture showing that palmar introsciae muscles, as their name shows, introsciae.
Pectoralis major muscle, sternum body deltoid muscle, and serratus anterior muscle, external oblique muscle, and linea alba, and in the same way linea seminiferus umbilicus, and superficial circumflex, and anterior superior iliac spine. In the same way inguinal ligaments, iliac crest, and oblique muscles of this upper limb. And in venous supply we have cephalic vein, basilic vein, and we have median antibrachial veins. So they supply this. And in the same way in arteries we have radial artery, ulnar artery, and brachial artery. And from here from mid clavicular we have Dvian axillary artery, and these are arterial and blood supply. Nerve supply include axillary nerve at level of C5-6-C6 and radial nerve. In the same way lateral antibrachial cutaneous nerve and radial superficial branch. From posterior view we have supraclavicular nerve, axillary nerve, radial nerve, lateral antibrachial branch, radial nerve, that supply this whole part of our arm.
Hope you all understand it well. Don't forget to subscribe to Medical Lexicon. Thank you so much.